What's up, guys? It's your boy Marcus J here, coming back with another video. Now, today we're talking about the producer JW Lucas and Tariq Nasheed. Now, a couple of days ago, hip hop producer named JW Lucas, that produced for the likes of Lil Uzi and the baby, said explosive comments over the death of Breonna Taylor. Now, this is the quote that he tweeted. Why is the world asking for justice for Breonna Taylor? Of course she shouldn't have lost her life, but do you realize that she was involved in multiple drug dealers who were using her house as a trap spot? If you sign up for that life, there are consequences. End quote. Now, this is just, I don't know, this white man is ridiculous. He just doesn't understand. He just doesn't understand. But Breonna was innocent in the situation. She wasn't even in a trap house, I believe. Could be wrong, but I think I'm right. And she was sleeping, so she was innocent. Now, Lucas and Tariq Nasheed, the guy who made the Hidden Colors, the Hidden Color films, and 1804 movies, you should check it out, definitely. And they got on live with each other talking about the situation, and he talks about how he is the most qualified to speak about black issues.
All right, so JW, why do you think you need to be a spokesperson for black people?
Because I feel that I have the fundamental understanding and the framework to bring real innovative ideas to the table. I understand. So you can, I understand the nature of reality. Wait. I understand the nature of reality. I understand game theory.
Black people don't have the fundamental understanding of reality.
I did not say that. I say I do not hear it when people are speaking about the cause. I've never heard anyone distinguish between cooperative and competitive games, and that's the issue we're having. This zero sum economy. This system that's the problem.
You're veering off, brother. Right now, you're
no, I'm not. I'm not veering off. This is the cause. This is the exposure to police brutality, the exposure to poverty.
We're talking about you right now, Jay.
And I have a level of understanding that I have not seen in the game. And I look at everyone, including yourself.
So you think that you're more qualified to talk about black issues than black people?
Yes, sir. Based on my fundamental understanding of the nature of reality, I say that with the utmost respect to you. I dedicate my life to this every day.
You just said that you're more qualified to speak for black people than us.
On the solutions, let's talk. No, we're talking about the actual ideas that are brought to the table.
What you want
to
do is practice.
And we can list the ideas.
Now, this guy, JW Lucas, he's just digging himself into a hole. He says to fight racism and all these things, but he wants to be the spokesperson for black people. That don't even make sense. I'm just shaking my head just watching this. I watched this like a couple times now, and I'm just like, this guy really did not just say that. He wants to be a spokesperson for black people. He's literally being the person that he's talking against. He's talking about racism and all this. And as you'll see later in the video, and he said he wants to be the spokesperson for black people. That's like an employee trying to be the CEO of a company. But Tariq Nasheed is right. Another race taking leadership is white supremacy. And whites have always had a history of this. They just try to dominate the other races. But let's take another look at this video.
Yes, we're having an intellectual conversation. We're not
just regarding that's very interesting. Admitted that you're more qualified to talk about black issues than black
and
people.
I clarified that's based on my understanding of
that's
quantum physics. The actual
sir.
Let me
and
speak.
That's what I
let me speak.
Establish.
I clarified.
I wanted to establish.
Listen, let me explain. Let me
and
explain.
You just admitted it. That
no, I did not. You're pinning that for your own individual gain. And that's bullshit.
I just asked you, sir.
And I began to clarify and let me speak. Listen,
about black issues with black people.
And I spoke to you. I clearly communicated. Let me tell you something. The reason why I agreed that, yes, I'm the most qualified to speak on it has nothing to do with
because
my skin.
White.
That would be contradictory to the message that I'm bringing. Skin color is irrelevant. We're talking about ideas. We're talking about fundamental understanding of reality and having the framework to speak about innovative ideas.
You're babbling now, brother.
No, I'm not. No, I'm not. You are babbling. You're not saying that you're pointing a picture. No, there's no white supremacist ideology.
We should not let people who are not in our culture get in our culture and try to
I am in your culture. Didn't you just hear a childhood friend of mine say that I grew up with all blacks?
You're having a colonizer mentality. You say
no, I'm not. I'm a colonizer.
So hip hop is the problem. That's what you're saying?
The narratives that are forced by the hip hop gatekeepers are the problem. Like the narrative.
Who are the hip hop gatekeepers?
You tell me who allows.
Who said, I don't know who you're talking about.
The narratives to be fed into hip hop.
Who are the hip hop gatekeepers?
Hip hop, whoever, the people that speak about the narratives, like the narrative that they need their rapper to be authentic, that they're not really living what they rap about. That is a narrative that perpetuates young men into believing that to have success in the music game, they got to have street cred, they got to have drip, they got to be a consumer. That's what prevents black ownership and economic advancement is these narratives in hip hop. Also, the narrative to fuck a bitch and send her home in an Uber pool. The narrative of running through women without responsibility is what's skyrocketing the single parent rate. Are you aware of the single parent? Are you aware of the single parent rate in America? And is it a problem?
You're a hip hop producer, right?
Yes, sir.
Why do you produce music like that?
Because I grew up listening to it, and I'm fascinated by hip hop music.
You know you're producing music that is detrimental to black society.
And at the same time I speak out.
Now, guys, this is just another classic form of white privilege because he's trying to claim another culture that's not his, that he does not truly understand. Because if he did, he would not be saying the things that he's saying right now. But Tariq Nasheed is right. You can't just infiltrate another person's culture because that is a form of white supremacy. But now, he talks about getting out of institutionalized racism in hip-hop and the negative hip-hop lyrics, but he's a producer. He produced for the likes of Lil Uzi and DaBaby, and they're part of the problem because they don't be talking about nothing because they don't got no substance. And at that, he's a white producer, so he's taking the dollars away from blacks. Rappers.
Do you think that Donald Trump is a racist?
I believe he said some things that were retarded, like retweeting the dude on the golf course, on the golf cart. I thought that was disgusting. But the fact is, Donald Trump just passed the First Step Act, which is the most aggressive prison reform in recent history, disabling what Bill Clinton, the liberal president, enacted with the three strikes you're out.
That
skyrocketed black incarceration rates.
So
black incarceration was skyrocketed by the liberal Bill Clinton.
So
he afterwards said it was his biggest mistake.
Okay, at this point, Tariq asks JW if Donald Trump is racist. JW proceeds to dance around the question like Michael Jackson and starts talking about prison reform and never answers his question directly. And he starts digging himself into a hole that he can't dig himself out of. But on a side note, don't you guys realize how he's barely letting Tariq speak? He just been talking over him and over him for this entire live. But I just want to go into one last point of this video.
Finish it up.
And I speak about real reparation ideas, like giving all black Americans $25,000 and $25,000 if they pull it into a business. It's all about
reparations ideas.
Huh?
What's your idea of reparations for black people? What do you think black people should
get? I believe that all black Americans deserve a $25,000 check where if they invest it into a business, they get another $25,000 check from the government.
Wait, hold up. What did you just say?
real reparation ideas, like okay, giving all black Americans $25,000.
I can't help but laugh when I hear that. $25,000 for the 400 years of white supremacy and racism, rape, suffering, injustices, taking of knowledge of self, wrong, all these things. $25,000 to start a business. Come on, bro. You can't be that stupid. I don't really want to get into this topic because I could make a whole nother week. I could go on forever talking about that topic. But in conclusion, this guy's an idiot. Doesn't know what he's talking about. It's just he doesn't understand the plight of black people in this country. But I'm going to leave the original video in the description. Watch it if you like. And like, comment, share, subscribe.